Hello. In today's tutorial, we'll embark on a thrilling technical adventure demystifying the ImageBind multimodal embedding model from Meta. The plan? We'll take the Meta model from the Vertex AI Model Garden and use a no-code, one-click deployment to get an easily testable ImageBind API. This is all constructed within Google Cloud Services. The basic concept should be portable to other clouds, but to follow along hands-on, you should have an existing Google Cloud account. So, without further ado, shall we dive in? Opening a fresh project in Google Cloud, let's venture over to the Vertex AI homepage. We'll switch on all the recommended APIs, unlocking a wide variety of Vertex AI capabilities. Then, let's explore the Model Garden to uncover Meta's new model. A quick way to find the model is by hitting the video button, since very few models cover that modality. Here, we have some example code for deploying and using the model. However, for the deployment, let's opt for the simpler GUI-based approach. Hit that tantalizing deploy button. A single L4 NVIDIA GPU should suffice. This is an efficient and cost-friendly model, which avoids the costly and high-demand accelerators like A100 GPUs, H100 GPUs, or the latest TPUs. Be prepared to wait a few minutes, but once the model's done deploying, it will emerge on our online predictions page. Our AI endpoints in Vertex AI can host a wide variety of models, including multiple models per endpoint, should you need to use ImageBind alongside other AI systems. In the sample request, sections of curl and Python code give us some help in how to hit this API endpoint. Remember the model garden entry? That example inference code can be helpful as well. For our multimedia inputs, the model needs specific formats and file placement within Google Cloud Storage. So before we start using the model, let's set the stage with the bucket and test files. Wikimedia Commons makes sense for a solid test file source. Let's pick out some images from the Picture of the Day series and store them in our bucket. How about amplifying our experiment with audio to test the multimodal characteristics? We'll find a narration of Mont Blanc and something related to our metal marble and light stick image. Just bear in mind that we need a waveform formatted file for the model inputs. Ultimately, we could venture into things like videos, but remember, videos are simply a combination of images and audio. The docs contain details about the sampling and the approach for those two underlying modalities. We'll often also experiment with text prompts. Now imagine bringing all these potent elements and unifying them. How might these diversify file types, dancing with some written text, create powerful embeddings for classification or recommendation systems? Let's head back to the endpoint and click into our model to explore. Notice the preview functionality here? This is a nice convenience that lets us test our model with minimal work and no code. Here in this box, we have our text inputs, various descriptors that match up nicely to some of the images and sound bites. The images and audio have carved out their space in the vision and audio sections. Plot twist, running the prediction returns a server error. This makes for an intriguing opportunity to sift through the endpoint logs and showcase debugging. A haystack of logs indeed, but the smoking gun is this 403 error. The endpoint service account is being denied access to the Google Cloud storage bucket. This is a quick fix. We navigate to permissions, grant access to the principal, and bestow the cloud storage viewer role. Retesting gives us an output. That permission step is the only hiccup. For the model's categorization work, we get combinatorial results where we match all the text against all the images against all the audio, and so on. Other than that, we have our model info at the bottom. The audio was a good starting point. We have two audio files, and what do you know, we have two associated results. We're checking each of these audio files against each of the images for semantic similarity. Now, let's dissect the first case. Recall that this is the audio where a voice speaks the words Mont Blanc. The middle option stands out in semantic similarity. That's great, and no surprise since that third image was a picture of a Mont Blanc. Let's shift to a text example. The middle text, a vivid description of a dome in Valencia, Spain, is especially similar to one of our images. The first image, a picture of exactly that dome, boasts an extremely high similarity score. Thus, we have zero-shot similarity and classification with confidence scores across our different modalities. In our broader testing, this model shows promising results, especially given the relatively low accelerator requirements. Don't forget, we've only skimmed the surface of the diverse input types for this exceptionally versatile multimodal model from Meta. For those seeking deeper insights and more advanced workflows, you have the freedom to use the embeddings themselves directly. Many thanks for tuning in, and please enjoy responsibly.